everybody, and welcome back to Wolf Tracks. I'm Jessica Schnabel.
And I'm Nathan Boehme. This is a program produced by the video production students of South Kitsap High School.
On this edition of Wolf Tracks, we'll show you how hands-on training is helping students learn how to keep South's athletes healthy and safe.
The FFA has been around a long time, but how are they doing in the high-tech 90s? We'll show you the new FFA.
There are a lot of talented artists at South. We'll take you inside the art department and get an up-close look at the creative process.
And meet the Wee Wolves of South Kitsap High School. Find out what high school students learn from small children.
It's an exciting feeling to take nothing and turn it into something. That's what happens every day in South's art department. Take a look. Art. It's everywhere, from the floorways to the hallways. Even South's garbage cans don't go unnoticed. As you see the variety of colors and the individual creations, you might come upon the question, who are the creators of these masterpieces? Students from the art department. The art department specializes in three different categories: jewelry, pottery, and drawing.
We have five things that we actually make. We make a tool in the beginning to work with the waxes, and that's made out of a simple welding rod and dowels. And after we make that tool, we start on our first ring, which is a basic band, simple band. The second ring they get to design, it's a ring of their choice. Then we do a two-material piece, which is a permanent material like silver and maybe set a stone in it, right? So that would qualify as a two-material piece. And the last project is something that we fabricate out of sheet metal, sheet brass, and brazing, you know, learn how to braze and solder a little bit too.
This area in here is the drawing and painting room, and it's also the crafts room. We have a couple crafts classes every trimester. In the drawing and painting room, and in the program, we do a preliminary kind of a beginning class, which is the basics, covers the techniques and the materials that we would use. And then we have three advanced classes. And in the advanced classes, we focus on subject matter. First trimester being self-expression in lots of different areas. And then second trimester, we do animals and people. And third trimester, we focus on landscapes, seascapes, and outdoor.
Now we're finishing up a cube project that they are glazing, and we just began a mug requirement. You can see some of the kids are starting to work on mugs. Essentially, there are five requirements in the class. First project is to create something recognizable, which is based somewhere on a sphere form. All of the things in the showcase here are somehow premised, even though it might seem rather abstractly, somewhere where they began with a ball and then altered it to create a three-dimensional recognizable sculpture.
Looks like fun to me, and if it looks like fun to you, check it out and make it one of your classes. Our school is definitely a more beautiful place thanks to the art department. Come by and take a look around sometime.
Every once in a while, when you walk the halls here at South, you round the corner and come face to face with a whole pack of little kids. Here's Pat Austria, who explains what they're up to.
This is South Kitsap's Wee Wolves Preschool. And believe me, these kids are ready to learn and, of course, have a good time.
Do you need a break from modern living? Do you long to shed your weary load?
Supervised by teachers Ms. Hewitt, Ms. Fairweather, and educational assistant Ms. Mueller, the class teaches the kids developmental skills in preschool.
Just kind of focuses on learning through play and themes. I learn how to wait in lines, wait patiently, sometimes sit still, raise your hand, that sort of thing.
My role is more of a facilitator. I teach classroom activities. My students do assignments. I don't actually work with the children on a daily basis, but help them to work with the children.
them being the students in Exploring Childhood class.
And you can take like Exploring Childhood, which is what this class is, and you just get to interact with the kids, and you're basically the teacher, and you plan for the whole class, and you have to keep them busy for like activity, which is kind of hard and really messy.
Where kids come in and we watch them, we get experience from the kids, and it's pretty fun.
Well, we have a theme every week of that like we always talk about, and this week it's vegetables, so we're making vegetable soup today.
Where little kids come and play together and learn and have snack time and play with us older kids.
When I asked the students what their funnest part in Wee Wolves was, they simply said,
"The children, the kids, I like playing with them."
I have a lot of fun with the little kids, I love kids.
The kids, it's gotta be the kids.
I am Marty. Maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me.
That was a television debut of the class of 2010. To be a kid again.
For many students who like to skateboard, it's gotten pretty tough finding a legal spot to skate. But all that's changed recently. Here's Jorday Zebor. Down in Mississippi where the sun beats down from the sky. They give it up and they give it up and they give it up, but they never ask why. Daddy was a roller.
The Port Orchard Skate Park was completed last summer, and on any given day, dozens of kids now have a place to hang out and practice their sport. We didn't get this park without a lot of hard work, and there was even some vandalism that made local headlines. Local skaters spent countless hours in fundraising projects to help pay for it, and more than 100 local groups like the Lions Club and Rotary pitched in money as well. $13,000 went into the project, and if you ask any of the skaters, you'll find it's well worth the money.
It's a really good place to go. Cool people, cool ramps, cool times. It's rad.
How many hours per week do you spend here?
I was gone pretty much most of the time, but I did help build some of it.
What ramps did you help build?
I helped build that pyramid and that other pyramid that people are sitting on top of, and I don't know, pretty much most of the ramps.
But even with this nice park, it's still a very dangerous sport. Jonathan Barnes is one of the youngest and best skateboarders here, but not long after we got these pictures, he wrecked and broke his leg. It's a great place. Drop by and watch it sometime, but not everyone supports the park. Last summer, before it opened, vandals attacked the park and destroyed the largest ramp. If you have any information about why they might have done it or who, please let the police know.
This spring, the skate park will get even better. Several new ramps will be built thanks to the donations of Port Orchard Eagles.
One of the most popular extracurricular activities here at South is FFA. Justin Kaiser explains how this longtime organization has changed throughout the years.
We call them cool, those hearts that have no scars to show, the ones that never do let go and risk the tables being turned.
The FFA has a long tradition here at South. The club has been around since 1932.
chance of sorrow and the shame that always comes with getting burned. But you've got to be tough when consumed by desire, 'cause it's not enough just to stand outside the fire.
For many years, FFA stood for Future Farmers of America, but now it is simply known as the National FFA Organization, because it is about much more than just farming.
Truthfully, the future shows that if we're going to feed the United States and the world, which we're going to be counted on doing, if we're going to grow foods, clothing, we're going to have a good water source, we're going to keep wildlife and vegetation, the environment healthy, it's going to be dependent upon the agricultural world, I think, to lead the way. One in five jobs, one out of five in the United States, deals directly with agriculture. And if we don't get the message out and let people know what they can do to help make this earth a better place, then we've made a big mistake. And we need to be the leaders in making sure that everybody understands that.
Standing outside the bar. Standing outside the bar. Life is not tried, it is merely survived.
FFA, it's great. You get to meet a lot of new friends. You get to go to fairs, and you get to learn a lot of about... I don't know what she's saying. You get to learn a lot about raising animals and how to take care of them and how to sell them, and you get a lot of experience in it.
But even though students are attracted by a variety of activities, many still are involved for a chance to work with animals. Some students are able to keep their animals right here at South in the school barn.
Life is not tried, it is merely survived if you're standing outside the fire. Standing outside the barn. Standing outside the barn.
Every year, one of the most popular FFA activities is the annual safety fair. At the fair, kids learn things like don't play with electricity, how to use 911, and other information to keep them safe.
Life is not tried, it is merely survived if you're standing outside the barn.
The next big event for the FFA is their holiday food drive to help local families. If you'd like to contribute, contact the FFA. Hey, Jessica. Do you own a car?
No.
Do you drive a car?
Sometimes.
Well, check this out. Here's Aaron, the car guy, Davison, with a tip on how you can get better gas mileage.
Hi, I'm Aaron, and I know that one of the hardest things to keep up with in car maintenance, especially for teenagers, is to have enough money for gas. Well, I have a simple tip today that will help decrease the amount of fuel that your engine uses, and it all has to do with your tires. That's right, having your tires improperly inflated can decrease your fuel efficiency by up to 2 to 3 miles per gallon. So here's what you do. You want to check in your owner's manual, or it should say right here along the side of your tire, how many PSI, pounds per square inch, you should have in each tire. This one right here says you should have 44 PSI. So you take this little gauge, and you pop it right there to check pounds per square inch. This one should have 44. There you go, 44. This tire is properly inflated, and I won't waste any money on gas. And that's all there is to it. This has been Aaron Davison with another simple car care tip. See you next time.
Why was that in Wolf Tracks?
Hey, come on. Aaron's a friend of mine.
So we run a car tip in Wolf Tracks?
Hey, I thought he did a good job. That was good information.
Oh my.
And speaking of friends, I'd like to introduce you now to another friend of mine.
Nathan has this episode of Student Spotlight.
With me today is one very talented senior who I've had the pleasure of working with in highlighters as well as concert choir. He's an extremely talented basketball player, and you may have seen him last year in the musical Oklahoma as Will Parker. With me is Luke Terry. Luke, thanks for being on the show.
Good to be here.
Thank you very much. So, I'm sure a lot of people out there also know that you are on homecoming court this year. Like, can you tell us what that was like for you? What was that whole experience like?
Well, it's basically, as I said, very surprising. As far as, you know, usually people are football players, cheerleaders. Of course, I wasn't a cheerleader, but, you know, when they said my name, it's just kind of, wow. Yeah. But, yeah, it is really fun.
So what went into it? What did you guys do?
Like, well, I don't know. Basically, we just, we had to plan for like a skit at a pep assembly, which was a lot of fun. And then planning for coronation, the whole formal thing about just walking down the aisle with your date. So
that's cool. So what was it like actually being up there though, like on the stage? What was that like to stand
well,
up with
you
all
have
those
to,
people?
You have to learn how to make a smile that's not cheesy when you don't feel like smiling, you just have to keep on smiling. That's a main goal, but yeah, you just stand there basically while people talk about you and then you sit down.
And you made it into the top three.
Yes.
Did you expect that? How was that?
No, not really. It's kind of, I guess everyone just thought, I don't know, there's that big guy, I'll vote for them or him or something. I don't know.
That was really neat though. Okay, what about this year? What are your plans this year? There's like been rumors floating around that you might be doing basketball this year, which you're really good at and everyone knows. But there's also rumors been floating around that you're going to do the musical again this year, which you did a great job in last year. And so there's been people on both sides kind of coming at you that way. What are you thinking about that? What are you going to do?
Well, I've been thinking both ways, and I think I'm going towards a musical. So that's, you know, I thought about it, and I thought about it both ways. And some days I really lean towards doing basketball, and other days I lean toward musical. But lately it's been pretty much that's what I want to do.
So the musical people out there will be really happy.
Yeah.
Basketball.
They'll be giving each other high fives. So
can't please everybody. Oh well. So what about your plans for the future? What are you planning on doing like after high school?
After high school. Well, I hope I get into some sort of college. And what college? I don't know. That really depends on my grades and stuff. But yeah, just college. Like, that's about as far as I don't want to hang around here for.
So you think you're going to go out of Washington?
Yeah, hopefully, yes. So I have to get a job, get some money, and then off to school.
Pretty much known. That's
yeah,
cool.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks for being on the show.
Oh,
it was great talking to you.
All right.
And we'll see you guys later in another episode of Student Spotlight.
Thanks, Nathan. A popular lunch stop here at South is the Student Store. Nothing beats a Snickers to get you through the day. Here's Andy Godsey with a look at how the Student Store helps students prepare for business career.
We all see them at lunch, the people who sell stuff at the Student Store. But a lot more goes into this program besides selling Cheetos and cup noodles.
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you.
Before they work in the store comes classroom instruction, and that comes from the advanced marketing class taught by Ms. Shauna Lamar.
Basically, the class is Introduction to Marketing, and the Student Store is the learning lab for the marketing class. So that's where they apply their customer service skills, their math skills, their cashiering skills, inventory control, etc. Basically, when they see the Student Store, it supports everything that DECA does, but it actually is not DECA. There's a lot that's learned in the actual classroom versus just the fun and exciting stuff.
Mrs. Lamar is the advisor for the business club called DECA. And running the Student Store is just one of the many projects.
And we've done a burn foundation where we helped, like, for all the people that were, like, they lost their house and stuff, and we helped them, you know.
People in the program, we all went for the day and did the AIDS walk and raised $250 for it, and it's just to benefit the community. And Destiny headed up the boot drive, and it's all just community service, just help out the community, because they help us out.
But it's not all work and no play. One big attraction to join DECA are the freaking conferences that give students a chance to travel and learn more about business.
People fill out an application, and from that application, the officers choose the best ones, and then we pick about 15 people to go to each conference, and then we assign the rooms So usually we're in rooms with our friends, and then there's a dance every night, and we stay in big, nice hotels that have pools and stuff, so it's lots of fun.
I don't know, you go to them and you go to seminars like during the day. So like little, like 2 hour conferences, 1 hour conferences.
Then at night we do chapter dinners. There's dances and casino nights for the students to participate in. So a lot of fun's thrown into it too. Then go out to dinner as a chapter, and then the next day they'll attend more seminars. They'll do a lot of active seminars. So they'll be doing games, leadership activities, lots of group activities versus just sitting and listening to somebody. So there's a lot of student interaction, group interaction.
So today, it looks like all they're doing is running the student store. But some of these students will be the business leaders of tomorrow.
Who knows? You might be working for one of those students someday. Now here's Nathan.
Getting hurt is an occupational hazard if you participate in sports at any level. Annie Godsey has a story on a popular class here at South dedicated to preventing and treating sports injury.
Injuries go hand in hand with playing sports, but working hard to prevent them are trainers who, among other things, tape and stretch athletes before they compete. At South Kitsap, this is a part of an instructional program called athletic medicine. Mr. Pat Olson is one of the two instructors.
There's a lot of careers it could prepare you for, and it doesn't even really have to prepare you for a career. It could be just as simple as being a good parent, knowing how to take care of your son or daughter when they get hurt doing their activity. But some of the professional careers you could go into would be a certified athletic trainer, like myself, a physical therapist aide, massage therapy, which is becoming a big profession, along with always the doctors and nurses, the typical medical career you could have gone into a long time ago.
The past 5 years, athletic medicine has been one of the favorites among students here at South. This year, more than 120 students are in the beginning and advanced classes.
You have to watch the whole time, and you have to push the players out of the way to be able to see, and you have to be assertive.
Is it ever a big rush where you have to like get somebody back in the game real quick?
Yeah, like whenever we play on turf, they always get turf burns on their elbows and they start bleeding, and we have to like clean it and bandage it and get it all taped so it'll stay and get it back on the field in a minute.
It's kind of hard to learn that special test to decide what's wrong with the person. If they have an injury, you have to do these tests, and some of them, you know, if there's just one little thing different to make it a different injury, and that's pretty hard to decide which injury it is.
Mr. Olson says he enjoys working with the students, but that it can be a challenge.
Really to teach them confidence in their own ability. Most of the kids that I get are very good students and very disciplined, time management wise, and so they have a good time with it, but just being able to learn how to hold on to somebody's limb or do a test correctly and be confident that what they felt was what was really happening. It wasn't just a bad test or their hands were in the wrong place, that they really got what they felt.
The athletic medicine program provides student trainers for every sport program here at South. Occasionally there are serious injuries, but most are common, simple situations.
Sports today aren't just one season long. Kids play 9, 10, 11 months out of the year doing the same thing over and over. So a lot of lower leg injuries, stress fractures, medial lateral tibial stress syndrome, which is commonly known as shin splints, some simple ankle sprains, finger sprains, things like that.
So the next time you hear about another outstanding South Kitsap athletic team, don't forget about the outstanding team of staff and student trainers who are excelling in keeping our athletes healthy.
Speaking of sports, the football team had another excellent season this fall. They made it to the first round of the playoffs before losing in a tough game to Redmond. But one of the highlights of the year was the homecoming victory over the Foss Falcons. By a decisive margin, the Wolves ran over Foss 61-14. There were lots of highlights that led to the points on the scoreboard, but as you'd expect in a game played on Halloween Eve, there were some strange occurrences, including sprinklers coming on and streakers running across the field during the third quarter. All in all, though, it was a great homecoming and a great season.
South has a long reputation for school spirit. In fact, the entire week leading up to homecoming is called Spirit Week. Pat Austria shows us what it's like in this video essay.
Have you ever wakened to hear sounds like these?
Got the refugees, all stars, rubber dubbing in the club. Wyclef Jean, Jean Forte, Roswell. Know what I mean? The streets are getting a little crazy. Look at here. Look at Shorty got back. Should I ask her for a dance? Hold on, there's too many in the wolf pack. And besides, dirty cats talking to her. Buying her fake furs and taking her to the fever. Why does this kept? They ain't even it's been. She's been since Franklin.
There's no tears in my eyes today. I've only got good things to say. Sun chased the way the clouds are gray. Going to heaven, I'm gonna stay. Oh, it's all smiles there.
Week was a lot of fun.
Yeah, everyone really got into the spirit.
Definitely.
Well, that's it for this episode of Wolf Tracks. I hope you learned something new about South.
Well, until next time, see ya. Welcome back to Wolf Tracks. I'm Jessica Schnabel.
And I'm Nathan Boehme. This is a program produced by the video production students of South Kitsap High School. Could we do that again?
Yeah. Our school's definitely a more beautiful place thanks to the Arpy Puppy.
Here's Pat Austria, who's explaining what they're up to. That wasn't the one.
But all that's changed recently.
That's really good.
One of the most popular extracurricular activities here at South is FFA.
Nathan has this story of
this episode.
A popular lunch stop here at South is the student store. Nothing beats a Snickers. Oh my god.
Hey. I said hey again. I'm in hey mode.
Okay, do it again.
That week was a lot of fun. Everyone really got in the spirit.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.